Hey everyone, GillicLawSports.com. We got asked about Renner's lane interference on this play. Take a look.
Slow roller, tough play. Arrieta pounces, throw to first, and it gets by. One run is in Adames. Narvaez going to keep on trucking, and two will score. Wisdom is down. A collision at first.
We were asked about runner's lane interference, so we're going to analyze it from an RLI point of view, even though Ross doesn't complain, no one seems to argue it. That doesn't indicate it's right or wrong, it just is something that happened, or lack thereof. Rule 509A11, in running the last half of the distance from home base to first base while the ball is being fielded to first base, runs outside the 3-foot line or inside to the left of, but not within, and in the umpire's judgment in doing so interferes. First thing to establish, yep, the ball is being fielded to first base. Thrown to first base, that's the same language. And yep, there's a collision, first baseman is unable to catch the ball. The question then becomes, was the runner illegal and could the throw have reasonably retired the runner if not for the interference? And as my Little League coach told me a long time ago, if the ball touches your glove and you miss it, that means you could have caught it. So we look at the replay and we see, yep, the ball touches and glances off the first baseman's mitt as the runner's coming in, but well before the runner actually gets there. So I would say, yep, it could have reasonably retired the runner. The reason, and again, you're going to say you're making excuses again from the last video with CB. I'm going to try to frame it in a different way. You know how players, when they miss a pitch, they miss swinging, they look foolish on a strikeout? You don't make excuses, but you have to watch the tape and understand what you did wrong or didn't do or why something might have happened so you can adjust for next time. And I'm going to try to do that here. So in this play, we're going to get another look at Rehack the Plate Umpire. And of course, I forgot to establish that the runner was running illegally, so let's establish that. But look at Rehack. He has to stay point of plate to look at the potential play at home plate. With the runner coming from third, the tag play at home plate, if it occurs, is way more important than runner's lane interference. So he can't get to first baseline extended to see the potential RLI. You see now he's first baseline extended until the runner is already near first base. And by then, it's too late to figure out if the runner entered the lane legally or not. The runner is entitled to exit the lane on the last step within a stride to touch first base, but that's only if the runner entered the lane legally and was running legally. If the runner's not in the lane, within the lane, the runner does not get protection. So it's tough when you don't see the totality of the play. It's like, do I give runner protection? Do I not? I don't know if the runner entered the lane legally or not, so I can't really make that call because I got to the extended line late because I had to wait for a potential tag play at home plate. That's the reason that Rehack does not see this. I'm not saying it's right, and I'm not saying it's wrong. I'm saying that given the umpiring mechanics, you have to stay point of plate to anticipate a play at home plate, because that play at home plate, if it comes, is 100% more important than RLI. And you can't look out of the peak, just like glance out of the corner of your eye to look at there at, toward first base, because then you're going to miss whatever the pitcher does, if the pitcher throws home, and you're not going to be in position, or you're not going to be in the mindset to see the play at the plate. So as soon as he sees Arrieta commit to first, only then can the umpire transition to first base line extended, and by that point, Taylor's already right at first base, and you don't know if he was legal the entire way, so you can't make the call because you didn't see it. The question I got asked is, can the first base umpire help out? And the answer is, yeah, absolutely. The first base umpire can set up in a way and take a look. It's primarily the plate umpire's call for RLI, but first base umpire, knowing that the plate umpire is stuck at point of plate or thereabouts, waiting for a potential play, can assist the crewmate. And you have to pre-play, pre-pitch this. You know replay that there's a runner at third, two outs, is going to head toward home plate. So the plate umpire might be busy on a little chopper to the pitcher. Especially when the pitcher's charging in and you think as a plate umpire, I know there are two outs, the pitcher can go to first base, but they might come here because it's a much faster, closer play. It's just like a toss as opposed to a full-on throw. And so for that reason, it makes sense that Rehack can't commit to first base until Arrieta commits to first base. And by then it's too late. Yep, first base umpire absolutely can help. That's what you would do after the play if the crew wanted to get together to talk about this. I don't believe that that's what happened. And again, Ross never argued. The Cubs didn't argue. The broadcast didn't pick it up. And in that case, it turns into an expected no call. And if it's an expected no call, there's really no harm, no foul on the field. This is just a theoretical Monday quarterback situation. Anyway, visit us online, closecallsports.com, Twitter and Facebook at Close Call Sports. Thanks for sending this in. We'll see you on the site.
This is going to be trying to get right in line.